Welcome to the tutorial. In this game, you will control one main unit and many other minor units to defeat your enemies. Use the WASD keys to control your main character. Navigate around the spike pits to proceed. Good! Up ahead are some enemy units. Your default attack is controlled with a spacebar. Destroy the two enemy units and proceed. Good. Before continuing, you should learn how to use your special move. Each main character has a different one. If you press and hold spacebar after attacking, you will see the charge bar under your life bar begin to fill. Continue holding spacebar until the charge bar is full, then release to use your special move. Use your special ability to help clear the next group of enemies. Well done. It looks like you're getting used to controlling your main character. Next, you'll be introduced to minor units. Ahead is a handful of controllable minor units. Using the mouse, you can select units individually, or drag a box around multiple units to select all within. Shift-click to add or remove units from your selection, and shift-drag to do the same for multiple units. All selected units will automatically follow your main character and engage in battle when enemies are nearby. You can also issue orders to your units by right-clicking the area you want them to attempt to walk to. Deselect units and they will stop following your character. You can deselect all units by clicking an open area. To finish this tutorial, use your men to help you kill the rest of the enemies in the area. Congratulations! You've completed the tutorial and should now be ready for the rest of the game. Have fun.
GML and the Genesis 14 Project. Before exploring the aspects of GML or the Genesis 14 project, let's first take a look at the backbone to what makes it all possible. GameMaker. Originally created by a Dutch computer scientist Mark Overmars in November 15, 1999, GameMaker started as a simple graphics creation tool called Amino, but evolved since then into what it is today. Now, a company called Yo-Yo Games is in charge of the program and is still developing it into a more powerful tool. The GameMaker program offers the use of 9 different resources, some of which aren't required, to put together games, all of which can be handled directly within GameMaker. These resources are sprites, or animated images, sounds, backgrounds, scripts, fonts, timelines, objects, and rooms. At its core, GameMaker is meant for amateur or emerging game designers with a focus on ease of use and intuition. With the features it has available, it is possible to program a game without actually writing any code. This is achieved through a drag-and-drop interface that allows users unfamiliar with traditional programming to create games by visually organizing icons on their screen. This, however, only covers a limited range of what is capable with the coding portion of the GameMaker program. To use GameMaker to its full potential, the GML scripting language must be used. GML, which is short for GameMaker Language, is a scripting language written for the GameMaker program. A scripting language is a programming language that controls a software application. Scripts are often regarded as different than programs, as they are usually specific to a certain type of software, as in this case, GML works only for GameMaker. The syntax for GML is much like that of Pascal or C, which often leads to the mistake in thinking these languages can be used directly in GML. This, however, is not true, as GML has many interchangeable syntax rules. One example of this is the ability to use the double ampersand interchangeably with the AND command. Using either will produce the same result. One interesting thing about the GML language is its dynamic typing attributes. What dynamic typing is, in essence, is a flexibility design that allows variable declarations and definitions without needing to state a variable type, for example, integer or character types. The closest thing we see to this idea in languages like C is generic typecasting, which allows the variable to be given an explicit type at a later time. With GML, this is all handled implicitly, and a variable's stored information can be changed at any moment during execution. The reason this sort of flexibility is obtainable with GML is because the code works a bit differently than compiled code like C or Java. In fact, the code isn't compiled at all. It's interpreted on the fly as the program executes. This idea is called pure interpretation. Because GML is an interpreted language, different sorts of flexibilities and setbacks exist. The two largest setbacks of any interpreted programming language are their speed costs and their file size. Because the code is never compiled, an interpreter needs to be packed into the executable file, instantly boosting the file size greatly. An empty GameMaker file is only about 13 kilobytes, whereas the same file, packed into an executable with an interpreter, is over 2 megabytes. Another interesting difference with interpreted languages is their debugging process. Because the code is never compiled, the only way to check it for bugs other than syntax errors is usually by running the code. But on the plus side, when the interpreter comes across an error in the code, it can tell you exactly where the error is in the code without needing to run a debugger program. As was earlier mentioned, one of the 9 resources used in GameMaker is objects. In most GameMaker projects, all of the game logic and programming goes into these objects. Just like other object-oriented programming languages, many of the quirks of the object-oriented paradigm exist in GameMaker. Particularly speaking, instances and classes play a big role in the object relationships. To better explain these two of the fundamental concepts of object-oriented programming, I will use the Genesis 14 project to illustrate.